Hey, it's me, Audrey Lee. Welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time visiting, then thank you so much for clicking. And if you're a returning visitor, then thank you so much for coming back. In today's video, I'm gonna tell you about one of my favorite hobbies, Disneybounding. I'm gonna go ahead and guess that most of you that clicked on this video already know what Disneybounding is, but apparently there are people out there who still don't know what Disneybounding is. Weirdos. Disneybounding was invented by a girl named Leslie Kay who wanted to go to Disneyland and kind of dress up, but not be in costume. So Disneybounding is really simple. It's paying tribute to your favorite Disney characters without actually being in full costume. Disneybounding is wearing an outfit that you would wear every single day to work, to school, out shopping. In fact, I'm Disneybounding right now. So let me tell you guys what Disneybounding is not. Disneybounding is not cosplay. Cosplay is full-on costumes. You got the wig, you got the outfit like exactly right, and you can't wear a costume into Disneyland. They won't let you in. You can't go in as Ariel. The reason that they have this rule makes a lot of sense. If a little five-year-old comes running up to you and you're dressed as full-on Cinderella, it could be a little bit confusing. Don't wear a costume into Disneyland. So how do you Disneybound? It's really simple. The first thing I would suggest that you do is go to your closet. Open the doors and just look at what you got. Do you have red jeans? Do you have a red skirt? Well, put them on, pair it with a plain black top. Ta-da! You're Mickey Mouse. Plop a red bow in your hair and bam! Minnie Mouse! Now the first time I Disneybounded was August of 2014, I believe. And I Disneybounded as the genie. Light blue on top, dark blue on the bottom, and a red belt. Genie, I, 10,000 years will give you such a crick in the neck. Now, if you absolutely can't find anything in your closet to Disneybound with, the next thing I would do is go to the thrift store. This is a really cheap way to find exactly what you need. The thrift stores that I go to often put like shirts and dresses like in groups by color. Let's say I wanna do Rapunzel. I'll just go right to the section that has like light purples and pinks, and I could just pull a shirt, $2, $3, there you go, you got a Disneybound. Sometimes when I'm looking for Disneybounding inspiration, I go to Pinterest. You can just type in a character that maybe you're thinking about doing, and you're gonna get all of these different ideas of how you can Disneybound them. One of the most fun and creative Disneybounds I ever saw was Wreck-It Ralph and Vanellope from the Wreck-It Ralph movie. This inspired me so much, I was like, oh my gosh, I love this. Disneybounding is amazing. The reason this is one of my favorite bounds is it helped me realize that you gotta think outside the box. They switched the gender roles, so, I mean, genius. It was so cute, right? I'm gonna put a link in the description below to Sarah's channel. It's like all things Disney, and if you're a Disney nerd, you're gonna wanna subscribe to her channel. Another Disneybounder that really inspires me is Lady Damfino. You can find her on Instagram at Damfino, D-A-M-F-I-N-O. She has this really cool way of like pairing her love for Disney with her love for like the vintage look, and it's so cool. And I just found out today that her name is Audrey. My name is Audrey. Audreys are pretty cool. Now I want to tell you guys about my favorite Disney bound. Last month I bounded as Rapunzel from the movie Tangled. And the reason this one is my favorite is because it's the most work I ever put into a bound. I got the dress from the thrift store and it was like, as soon as I saw it, I thought Rapunzel. It was like the perfect purple. Instead of just wearing the dress, I actually went to the crafting store and I got some ribbon and I got some flowers. And I actually sewed, which I am not a seamstress. Sorry, Mom, but I did sew some ribbon onto the dress and I added the flowers with hot glue gun, so easy. And it turned out really, really nice, I think. So here are some pics of me in some of my other favorite Disney bounds. If you'd like to see me Disneybounding and meeting the character that I'm Disneybounding as, you can click here for Rapunzel or here for Cinderella. Thank you so much for watching this video all the way to the end. Make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe. I am new to YouTube, so I appreciate all of the feedback and all of the support. Now, for all of you that are regular Disneybounders, go ahead and comment below what your favorite Disneybound ever was, and the first person to comment on who I'm Disneybounding as in this video is the winner! Winner, winner, chicken dinner! I mean, it's not really a prize or anything, but, you know. Vuxen!